Hi guys, my name is Sean. I'm a houseplant enthusiast from Jakarta, Indonesia. Welcome to today's video. We're going to be discussing some of the key differences between indoors and outdoor plant care. And disclaimer, I live in Southeast Asia, in case you don't know where Indonesia is. And we have a very tropical climate, so I'm going to be referencing a lot of that in this video. And I want to add that a lot of the Indonesian plant parents keep our plants outdoors, with exception of a few people who keep them indoors, possibly because of constraints of outdoor space or because they are apartment dwelling. So the bottom line in this video is that you can actually care for most plants indoors or outdoors. The care may be slightly different, as certain species may thrive better indoors versus outdoors. But generally speaking, you can do a lot of hacks indoors to keep your plants happy, and I'm going to try to share as much as I can. But I'm going to organize this video by describing to you each of the variables and go through with them in great details. Number one, the thing that you have to consider is lighting. When plants are living outdoors, they're most likely getting more light. But I wanted to put a disclaimer here that there could be buildings, trees, and things like that in our walls in the way. So I want to give you that advice with a grain of salt, because not all outdoor spaces are brighter. However, the problem with being indoors is that we look at a plant placed in a spot and we think, oh, that looks great, it's so bright there. But in fact, the plant may be sitting a little bit away from window, and all it sees is a window where the light source is coming from. So a lot of times when we're keeping our plants indoors, we're giving our plants less light than we think, especially a lot of people who are keeping their plants in shelves. For example, I'm just going to grab the closest plant here. If you put this plant under a shelf, a shelving unit, it's not going to get much light because the top portion is going to be blocked off. So it's only going to get whatever little light that it can get from whatever window that the light is coming from. So the best way to gauge light levels when you're keeping your plants indoors is to just use your camera. Put your camera where the leaf is and just take a video and see what the leaf sees. Be a compassionate and be the plant, basically. And one tip about indoor growing is that you can actually supplement your plants with artificial light. And you don't really have to get all those fancy grow lights that are purple in color. You can actually use any types of household light bulbs, like your LED, fluorescent. Those will do as well. I don't really know exactly the measurements of the light levels because I don't have a light meter and I don't usually go there, but I do know that they make a significant difference in your plant's health when you can supplement them with some kind of artificial light. So the bottom line is, outdoors, generally speaking, more light than indoors. With indoors, you gotta just be a bit more careful, because sometimes a little bit of light coming in from the window may look very bright to you, but it may not for the plant. The next variable would be watering. And when you're growing plants indoors, they actually dry out a lot slower than they do outdoors. This is the same theory as, for example, if you're doing laundry and you're hanging your laundry out to dry, you want to hang them outside, not indoors, because it's going to take so long to dry indoors. So this same principle applies to your house plants, where it's easier to overwater your plants indoors, so you really do need to back away with watering frequency when you have your plants kept indoors. Well, I actually have my plants outdoors, and I have over 1,000 plants. So what I do is that I actually just hose them down daily or when I need to. So it's very, very time efficient for me to care for them that way. But I started my plant journey with small collection of plants all here, right here in my bedroom, and I used to walk them to the sink and water them one by one. I actually do enjoy that process. I love watering my plants. I like checking in on them, and I miss that very much. So depending on what kind of plant parent you are, I'm not going to say which is better than the others. Just be mindful that when it's indoors, you may have to spend a little bit more time watering your plants. You may have to test them more often, bring a moisture meter, and make sure that you're not overwatering them. And you may have to bring them to the sink, because you may get messy with water if you water them on the table or wherever you have them. When you're having them outdoors, it's less likely to overwater them, and you can just hose them down. I do have a video of me watering my outdoor plants, so I'm gonna attach that up above. It's quite a satisfying video to watch. The third would be humidity, and this affects even us here in a tropical climate, where humidity would actually be a little bit lower indoors than it is outdoors. I guess it may have to do with evaporation rate, meaning that it rains outdoors, so all the rain and the water that seeps into the ground will evaporate, causing higher humidity than those of us who are indoors all the time with no kind of water getting in on our floors, our tables, and our walls. But Another thing to consider is that when we have our air conditioning on, especially here in the bedroom, the humidity actually dips down a lot lower. So for example, the humidity outdoors in Indonesia, in my climate, is around 80 to maybe 95% outside. But when it's indoors with the air conditioning on, it can drop to around 55 to 75% humidity, especially at night when the air condition is more on full blast. So different species of plants actually require different types of humidity. For example, cacti and succulent don't do really well outdoors here in my climate. They don't like 95% humidity. Whereas a lot of our tropical house plants, they do appreciate humidity, and a lot of my propagations actually do better outdoors where the humidity is a bit higher. The next difference is airflow. Obviously, indoors, you do have a more stale kind of air. This only affects a few types of plants, for example, your orchids, your air plants, some bromeliads. They do require excellent airflow because they do take in nutrients and moisture from the air. But most other plants actually do like some kind of airflow too. A lot of our high humidity loving plants, if you, for example, the Orbifolia here, if you put them in high humidity but with no airflow, they're going to rot. They don't like that at all. So just keep that in mind, that humidity has usually should go hand in hand with airflows to keep the plants healthy. A lot of you guys are growing plants in green, in small greenhouses, like your IKEA greenhouses. And I'm not sure, do you guys use fans in your greenhouse? Because you do need airflow with humidity, or else a lot of the plants are going to get moldy, you're going to get fungus and bacteria on the leaf. So just keep that in mind, that when you have high humidity, you do need good airflow. But yeah, a hack with indoor plant keeping is that you can actually keep a fan on. Or in my case, sometimes I have the AC on at night or when I'm going for extended period of time. And of course, now that it's COVID, I don't really leave my place anymore. But you could also leave, I see a fan over there. You could just leave a fan on in the room because this will help circulate the air better. So this is one hack for those of you who are keeping plants indoors. Try to keep a fan on. Get your air circulation going. It's going to help your plant a lot. Another thing that I want to quickly cover is misting. Well, you can actually safely mist your plants when it's outdoors because it will evaporate within, I don't know, 5 to 10 minutes. It's going to be so fast. But when it's indoors, just be a bit more careful when you mist the plant, especially on the leaves. You can encourage bacteria and fungus to grow on the leaves because sometimes they would stay wet for too long. And the next variable is an important one, and I guess this is on a lot of your minds, and that is pests. Actually, indoors and outdoors both have pests. Most of you may think that, oh, if it's outdoors, you're going to be fine. But no, it's a different problem, but it is also a big problem. Now let me explain. I have a perfect example here. This is a Philodendron gloriosum. And look at this baby leaf here. It is being chewed up by something. And I have plants, if you've seen my earlier videos, that are completely decimated by caterpillars, grasshoppers, snails, and even rats. They would eat the whole foliage. When you have your plants outdoors, you have bigger pests, or at least pests with big teeth and big stomachs. They will eat the whole plant. However, I'm usually not that worried because I know that plants usually bounce back even though they have no leaves. If the plant gets eaten up completely, I'm not that worried. I have a mindset where, yeah, I don't have to take it personally. I need to forgive quickly, and that the plant will always come back if you care for it properly. I do have a video on that, on plants that came back from a stump, so do check that out. But when you have your plants living indoors, you have smaller pests. I have a lot of scale mealybugs and also spider mites for plants that are kept indoors. First of all, plants are a little bit more stressed out when they're living indoors, which is why they attract all these pests. And also, there's no natural predators when you're living indoors. Whereas these plants that are outdoors, actually I do see spiders crawling around sometimes, and the spiders are actually feeding on your mealybugs, your scale, and your aphids. So they protect the plant from those tiny pests. Now, again, back to indoors, when you have lower humidity, for example, spider mites thrive in low humidity and when the plant is stressed out. So with their population unchecked, these tiny pests will actually kill your plants quite slowly. So these are the key differences between indoors and outdoors. In both cases, pests have to be controlled differently and they're both managed in a whole different way. So I can't say what is better and what's not. I'm just saying that I experience both of these issues and I deal with it. And pest is something that I will be addressing quite often on this channel in the future, so be sure to stay tuned. Okay, so moving on next, nutrients. So nutrients is going to be a little bit different indoors and outdoors. First of all, when you have your plants living outdoors, you're going to water them a little bit more heavily, which means that nutrients are going to be used up quickly, or at least flushed away very quickly by the water. So keep that in mind. You may want to fertilize your plant a little bit more if it's outdoors. But another interesting thing is that when you have your plants outdoors and it gets rained on, that's actually amazing for them, because rain water actually contains a lot of oxygen and nitrogen, which creates aeration within the potting mix. But they also unlock a lot of the nutrients in your potting mix. For details on fertilizing and nutrients, do check out my video above on fertilizing. You will find that very useful, and it's quite an important part of plant care actually. Another factor is that when you grow plants outdoors, you're going to get a lot of imperfect leaves. For example, a lot of the leaves are going to be torn by the wind and the rain, or just, well, in my house around here, we have bats and birds just flying around, and I've seen some birds crash land onto my balcony. I'm looking at it now, my balcony glass. So there are a lot of animals just being rough out in nature, and it will damage your leaf. You'll sometimes just break a leaf in half, and there are sometimes insects just fighting or doing something naughty on your leaves, causing a lot of tears and damages. So just keep that in mind, that when you have your plants outdoors, you're not going to get perfect leaves. However, when you have your plants indoors and you keep them in very good condition, in which there's no bacteria and fungus attacks, and it just got a good healthy immune system because you did give it good light, good airflow, and you did give them very good nutrients, so they have a really strong immune system. Anyway, the list goes on. But basically, when you have your plants grown indoors in good conditions, they can actually sprout some really beautiful and perfect leaves, and there can be cleaner leaves too. A lot of these plants, I'm looking at this right now, when you're kept outdoors, they can get a little bit dirty because dust do settle on them. And a lot of my plants actually got pooped on by birds and bats and lizards and things like that. So I somehow have to clean poop off the leaves of plants when they're outdoors. So yeah, I actually prefer to keep plants indoors for that reason, because I love to look at the perfect leaves. I guess the next thing that I want to address, when you have your plants living outdoors, and I know that a lot of you guys are saying, oh, you live in such a perfect climate, you have your plants outdoors. The biggest problem with outdoors is actually rot. And rot is caused usually by fungus. And I have this really good example here. This is the Calathea musaica. And a lot of my plants actually died this way recently, where they were kept in the outdoor garden, and there's a wall of, like, I don't know, like a trailing plant with like a lot of leaves. So then these leaves would die off and fall into this pot. I'm going to show you some close-up videos on this. And then when these leaves fall into the pot or into the foliage, some of my other plants in my nursery are actually quite bushy. So it's actually very difficult to pick out these dead leaves. What happens is that these dead leaves will cause what they call southern blight, and it is a very, very, very deadly and very fast-moving fungus. And I did address this in my Dischidia oleantha video, which I'm going to link up above, so you can see what the problem looks like. But this Calathea is actually going to suffer from that soon. I'm already seeing some of its issues, and it's starting to rot. So yeah, I do see those fungal spores in here. So once the fungal spores activate, it's going to decimate, it's going to completely eat this plant alive. And there are also other issues with rot, with in terms of having high humidity and a lot of fungus. So fungicide is very, very essential in plant care in my tropical climate, especially now that it's rainy season between December to February. I have to spray fungicide on all my outdoor plants very religiously. I would say every 2 to 3 weeks, I have to be on top of them. Imagine I have over 1,000 plants, so a few of them already died. I just basically took the whole pot, and I saw that it's problematic. Just dumped the whole pot the contents of the pot into the trash, because I couldn't deal with it. It's just plants turning into mush. Some of them that I, like my Dischidias, I actually saved them because they're so slow growing and I can propagate them. And yeah, so plant care in the tropics, yes, we do have a lot of benefits, but there are a lot of crazy issues that we have to deal with. You know, again, southern blight, we have your snails, grasshoppers, caterpillars, and all that stuff. And a final bonus point before I let you guys go is that I actually miss having a lot of plants here in my bedroom because I used to do a lot of my plant care at night. I would check on them, I would check for new growth, and then I would sometimes would propagate at night and things like that. I would appreciate them. But now that most of my plants are living outdoors, simply because I can't care for all of them indoors anymore. Obviously, you can't really check on them at night. First of all, there's outside, it's super dark at night. There's a lot of mosquitoes. There's snakes outside. There are bats and things like that. So I don't venture out at night. And I kind of miss that experience of having my plants around at night where, you know, sometimes before you go to bed, you know, you just want to kind of say goodnight to your babies, see if there are any new growth. Yeah. So that's something that a lot of you guys who are growing plants indoors can enjoy. You can care for them 24 hours a day. You can appreciate them at any time, I guess. So I guess that's all I have to talk about in regards to indoors versus outdoors plant care. I like both. Feel free to comment down below if you have any thoughts or ideas or want to share how you've been caring for your plants. I'm at Botanist on Instagram. If you want to DM me on any questions regarding plant care and propagation, I'll try my best to get back to you. Meanwhile, do take care and stay safe. I will see you in the next video. Bye.